this book, where I kept my collection of coins. It used to be bigger.
Oh, no, 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 no. We won't let this stand, right, Sherry? I want to find my coins.
It's going to be difficult. The sands of time, you know? Some things may have changed, but you're right. We can't let Mycroft win.
Merhaba.
Yeah. 12 zucchini first ever minted. This was part of Father's original collection. He won it at an auction in Barcelona the same year I was born. Antonio Manuel de Villena, the Grand Master of Malta, one of the first to mint his own coin. They were rather short-lived, unfortunately. Tari. This coin was once stolen from Father. Many years later, Mycroft found it in a private collection and persuaded the owner to return it. This coin depicts Hompesh, the last Grand Master of the Order to govern in Malta. I believe this coin was minted during the French occupation.
That was the third.
Mm-hmm.
one of a kind made as a proposal to the British Secretary of State. This design was rejected, and all successive copper coins had a seated figure of Britannia. A British grain to replace the Habba on Malta. Mother had a relative in the Maltese government who gave this unique coin as a wedding gift.
That was the third in a row, and
an acture called Asper by the British. One of the first Ottoman silver coins dating back to the 15th century. They minted them in Serbian Despotate. It bears a tura, the unique calligraphic seal of a sultan. Mycroft received this coin as a gift from a prominent Turkish family in Cordona for some favor. No sign of a hint. The vase was broken recently, though. Perhaps the vandal left some tracks. Looks like our little vandal is a dog. Let's see where he went. Kourouche, or piastre, a large silver coin now replaced by the gold lira. Suleiman II minted them, part of his attempt to revive the failing economy. This coin was gifted to me by Mycroft. He told me that he won it in a game of cards, but I can hardly see Mycroft playing, well, anything. A Zecchino of the Republic of Venice. This one dates back to Marino Faliero, who was executed for attempting a coup. Big ambition, poor organization. One wealthy collector wanted this coin so badly that he dared to intrude upon my father's funeral to convince mother to sell it. Mycroft showed him the door. Ancient silver grosso. It was first introduced under Doge Enrico Dandolo and quickly became a dominant coin of Mediterranean commerce. Mycroft returned with this coin from Venice. It was a long trip, but I don't remember any stories. Mycroft never talked much about any of his trips. A yellow boy or guinea. This coin was minted from the gold mined on the Guinea coast of Africa. It's considered a more gentlemanly currency than the pound. Huh, rarity. I don't remember how this coin got into the collection. It must have been a late addition by Mycroft. A real English double florin. This one is from the 14th century. I think they discovered two of them in the River Tyne. No others are known to exist. Mother's shrewd deduction revealed an archaeological El Dorado back in England. This coin was just a part of what she and my father dug up.
Thank you.
Right. Now, back to the coin. Cordonian Mangear, one of the last to be minted from local silver. The governor gifted this coin to Mycroft for his invaluable help. My brother added it to my collection, but the sight of it always made him frown.
We've got them all, Sherry. Let's get back to the manor. I know just the room for our coins.
I hope you're not suggesting my room.